Our next project is Egyptian art. And for Egyptian art, you're going to create your own tomb painting. But it'll actually be a scratch art piece. And the Egyptians really love their gold. So you are going to make a scratch art piece that is black with gold underneath. You have two options. You can make your objects gold, or you can make the background gold and just the details in your objects. You can make those gold. This one will take a little bit more time, quite a bit more time actually, but as you can see, it's really shiny. It's very pretty. Either one is fine. Your resource for this page is the Egyptian art folder, and on the back of your folder are your instructions. The figures must be drawn in strict Egyptian style, the head and profile, the torso facing the front, both arms and head are showing, hips and feet are in profile. You're going to stop the video now and you're going to practice this. For this composition, you're going to fill the entire space. So you want to make sure that you have it filled. Think about it like a suitcase. You're packing the suitcase for the afterlife, and you want it jam-packed with everything that you want to take to you to the next life. So you want to make sure that there's space in between each object, but they shouldn't be touching, but there shouldn't be too much negative space in between each object. You need to include the following on your Egyptian tomb. Choose a god or goddess to represent you. This should be the central figure and larger than any other figure. So if you want to put another figure in there, if you want to take your friends or family with you, they need to be smaller than you because you're the god or goddess and you are more important. Draw three objects you will need in the afterlife. For example, food, clothes, entertainment, furniture, cosmetics, which is makeup, household goods, and personal belongings. So here you could bring with you your iPod, your MP3 player, your Wii, your TV, your bed, your clothes. You could bring jewelry, food. If you want to live off of ice cream and french fries in the afterlife, that's fine. You can do that. Then you're going to draw three Egyptian symbols. Those symbols are in your packet, and I'll show you that in a minute. One of the symbols, so it's actually four. It says three here, but you're actually going to include four. Three are your choice, and then you're going to include the water symbol. And the water symbol looks like this. Then you're going to write your name in a cartouche in hieroglyphics. And don't forget the bling bling, baby. The Egyptians loved their gold. So let's look at this packet now. It's divided up with tabs. So to find your gods and goddesses, you find the tab, turn, page, and then this section is your gods and goddesses. This section will tell you about the gods and goddesses. You can choose any god or goddess you like, as long as they're in the strict Egyptian style. The head has to be in profile, shoulders, torso, facing forward. The hips and the legs and the feet are in profile. This size is what you're going to use on your final project, because you need it large enough that you can get the details in and so that it is the central largest figure. Now, as you're doing this, you're going to trace these on tracing paper. And as you're doing it, if there's a hand, for instance, this hand is not showing. So you should draw the entire thing and then turn your paper around so that you can trace either a different someone else's hand, or if you want this guy, but you want the arms in this position, you need to trace all of this and then trace the arms in the position that you want them. Now, as long as you follow the strict Egyptian guidelines, you can have your figure, your god or goddess, doing anything you want them to. They could be drawing, they could be writing, they could be playing their Wii, football, listening to their iPod, talking on the phone, texting. They can do anything you want them to do. Here we have more gods and goddesses. These are way too small to draw on our final project, but these examples will show you the god or goddess and their name and what they are about, their symbol, what they symbolize. Now you can choose your god or goddess based on what they symbolize, or you can choose it based on what they look like. You can just say, oh, they look really cool. Now this one, you couldn't use this one because it's not a figure in the strict Egyptian style. Also, this one, Bes. Bes is facing forward here. He's not in the strict Egyptian style, so he would not work either. If there's a god or goddess that I don't have in this book that you'd like to use, you may, but it is your responsibility to bring in a picture if that's what you'd like to use. You're going to choose three Egyptian symbols. And the Egyptian symbols, here's your tab for the Egyptian symbols. They will be in this section here. These you are more than welcome to look at and choose from, but on our final project, these are too small. I've enlarged these. I left this page in there so you have a quick reference. And here you have the symbols and what they mean. And again, you can choose based on what they mean or based on the fact that you think they look cool and you want to put them in your tomb. Either one is fine. We call that artistic license. These are the size that you need to use for your final project. These are going to be large enough that you will be able to get your scratch art tool in there. If it's too small, the scratch art tool is really difficult to use if it's too small. Here's your brainstorming list, and you are going to complete the brainstorming list for the afterlife. And these are all your choice. There is not one thing here that I'm going to tell you that you have to put on there as long as you follow the categories. This page is all or nothing. I want every single blank filled in, or I won't give you points for this at all. So you need 10 things that you use every day. You need 10 of your favorite things to do, 5 of the most important people, and I put animals on there too. If you want to include an animal in the afterlife, that's cool too. 3 things that you're most proud of. What would you like people to remember about you? So are you proud of your abilities in sports? Are you proud of your friendships? Are you proud of your faith? Are you proud of your grades? Are you proud of your attitude? What are you proud of? Are you proud of being able to skateboard, ride a horse, speed skate? Whatever it is that you're proud of, 3 things that you're proud of.
When we arrive, sons and daughters, we'll make our homes on the water. We'll build our walls, aluminum, we'll fill our mouths with cinema now. These currents pull us across the border. Steady your boats, arms to shoulder, till tides all pull our hull aground, making this call. Harbor now, home. Take up your arms, sons and daughters. We will arise from the bunkers, by land, by sea, by dirigible. We'll leave our tracks untraceable now.
Yeah.
you're going to write the names of three Egyptian symbols and draw them in the space below. These are three symbols of your choice. Any three symbols you like. You're going to write the name of the symbol here and draw the symbol there. You have three symbols here, and then you're going to choose your god or goddess to represent you in the tomb drawing. Write the name of your goddess here, or god, and then you're going to draw the god or goddess here. Now this page, I'm not really concerned about it being really perfect. The drawings, they're really about you observing, about you looking at the object, looking at the god or goddess, noticing what they're wearing, and drawing a representation of them. But if it's not a perfect drawing, I'm not worried about that.
It was a cold night, and the snow lay round. I pulled my coat tight against the falling down. And the sun was all, and the sun was all down. And the sun was all, and the sun was all down. I am a poor man, I have wealth nor fame. I have my two hands and a house to my name. And the winter's so, and the winter's so long. And the winter's so, and the winter's so. And all the stars were crashing round as I laid eyes on what I'd found. It was a white crane, it was a helpless thing upon a red stain with an arrowhead swing. And it called and cried, and it called and cried, so. And it called and cried, and it called and cried, so. my crying wife arrived at my door in the moonlight. All star bright and tongue-tied, I took her in. We were married, and bells rang sweet for our wedding in our bedding was ready. We fell in. Sound the keening bell, see it's painted red, soft as fontanelle, the feathers in the thread. When all I ever meant to do was to keep you my crane wife, my crane wife, my crane wife. We were poorly, our fortunes failed. Keening bell and see it's painted red, soft as fontanelle, the feathers in the thread. When all I ever meant to do is to keep you my wife, my crane wife, my crane wife. There's a bend in the wind and it rakes at my heart. There is blood in the thread and it rakes at my heart. It rakes at my heart. Heart. Heart.
spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong, and I learned how.